أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين منفكين حتى تأتيهم البينة. رسول من الله يتلو صحفا مطهرة فيها كتب قيمة.
Now, we get to the second ayah. You know, Allah says, al-bayyina, the clear proof. What's the explanation of what that clear proof is? رَسُولٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ يَتْلُو صُحُفًا مُطَهَّرًا. We're going to read Imam al-Alusi rahimahullah. وَالْبَيِّنَةُ عَلَى مَا قَالَهُ الْجَمْهُورُ هُوَ مُحَمَّدٌ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ لِأَنَّهُ فِي نَفْسِهِ بَيِّنَةٌ وَحُجَّةٌ ولذلك سماه سراجا منيرا وقد فسر الله سبحانه هذه البينة الجملة بقوله مع الجملة بقوله رسول من الله so this ayah itself is proof. Allah says until the clearest evidence didn't come, they would not be ones to separate themselves. And what is that clearest evidence? The messenger himself. But the ayah says two things. رسول من الله يتلو صحفا. A messenger from Allah. And by the way, Rasulun has tanween. This is for Mufid al-Azma. Instead of saying Rasulullah, we normally say Rasulullah, right? This ayah says Rasulun min Allah. It separates and puts a tanween on Rasul. This is Mufid al-Azma. Okay? A magnificent messenger from Allah, you would have to translate. An awesome messenger from Allah. Yatlu, that reads onto people. Suhufan mutahhara, purified scriptures. This is this two-part thing, the messenger and the message. When these two come together, then you have bayyina. Then you have al-bayyina. This is a very important concept in Islam. Islam is not just theory. You know, you can have a theory, a philosophical theory, an idea, and you say, this is the truth. And we say in Islam, that's not enough. To have an idea is not enough. If the idea is actually truth and there's good in it, then it should be something you can implement. But in and of itself, a theory, a concept, isn't good enough. Unless you see it in action. And this is the biggest obstacle to the da'wah of Islam in our time. You can show people the proofs of Islam. You can show people the wisdom of Islam. But when you look at the practice of the Muslims, it undoes all your da'wah. It's undermining all the da'wah of the Muslims, their behavior. Oh, if the book is saying all of this, and if your religion is so good, how come your own people don't follow it? How come your own people don't live by it? How come you people aren't as honest in business as your book says you should be? How come you don't treat your women the way your book and the sunnah of your messenger says you should treat them? Right? But in the end, the heart of the matter is, a clear proof, a clear message is one that in theory sounds convincing, and in practice it can be observed. Now that's absolute proof. So Allah Azza wa Jal says, the absolute proof isn't just Qur'an, it's رَسُولٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ يَتْلُو. It's a magnificent messenger from Allah who's reading onto you or who's reciting suhufan mutahhara, purified scrolls and scriptures. That's what he's doing. So this is the first thing, combining the messenger and the message into one. And this again, this is the ultimate hurdle to the da'wah of Islam in our time. We invite people in theory. We give them a pamphlet, we give them a book, we tell them listen to a speech, watch this video. All of that is what? All of that's theory. All of that's theory. That is empty unless you have what? Practice. Until they see the behavior of the Muslims. Until they see the honesty of the Muslims. Until they see how the Muslim treats their neighbor. Until they see how the Muslim deals in business. Until they see that, then this is just one side of the picture. That's not enough. That's not real da'wah. So Allah Azza wa Jal makes it clear that you cannot separate the messenger from the message. The carrier of the message should reflect the teachings of that message. Being a good orator, a speaker, a writer, that's not enough. That's just one side of the coin. The other side, our speech must match our action. لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Why do you say what you don't do? وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Who could be better in speech who calls to Allah and acts righteously? Allah combines the two, as He does in this amazing ayah.